Hello. I am Anonymous. Or rather, an individual branch of that organization. Speaking in the context of an individual, it is my personal conviction that a belief in religion is not inherently good or evil. I'm not going to tell you what to believe. That said, there are those who find that the conduct of the leaders of the organized religion called Scientology is questionable. Scientology, as Scientology is neither good nor evil, the word itself simply means study of the truth. As a religious individual myself, I can find no fault in any person or group of persons for finding something to believe in, but faith can, just as easily, paint the way to deception as propaganda. Scientology has been guilty of incidents of violence and human rights violations countless times. Consider Lisa McPherson, who died under suspicious circumstances, while under the care of the church, or Paulette Cooper, whose criticisms of Scientology led the church to conspire towards the creation of a plan to have her imprisoned or committed into a mental institution. Investigate. The facts speak for themselves. Yet the true victims in all this are not the self-deluding leaders of Scientology or even the people they have hurt, but in the believers who support them. The driving force behind any faith is the people who believe in it, and the believers of Scientology have been misled on a level that is tragic. But the deception on part of the leaders does not truly reveal all that Scientology does to retain their faithful. The truth is that the organization of Scientology is based on fear. And that is the true architect of all that Scientology's leaders have accomplished. Fear. Fear and terror. There are many reported instances of former believers in Scientology stating that the church played towards the fears of the individual to ensure continued devotion. Fear. Who wouldn't be afraid? A seemingly almighty organization which smashes all those who show even the slightest sign of opposition would scare anyone. Scientology promises that through belief in the church, one can find truth in the world. And all that need be exchanged for that is silent, obedient consent. Where, once the average believer had the freedom to criticize, we find that the church has stretched its grasp into the internet, attempting to censor further any criticisms against it or its leadership and investing in systems of surveillance to coerce conformity and to monitor what it describes as religious persecution. Anonymous wishes no harm upon anyone. We have looked at Scientology objectively and have found that the crimes it has committed against believers and non-believers alike both heinous and distasteful. The church needs to be brought to justice. Anonymous seeks to remind the public and the world at large of something that it has forgotten, that fairness, justice, and freedom are more than just words. They are perspectives. So, if you have seen nothing, if the crimes of Scientology's leaders remain unknown to you, then I would suggest that you allow the past few minutes of this video to pass unmarked in your life. But if you see what I see, if you feel what I feel, then I ask that you too, join Anonymous. Be aware, Anonymous is coming. Expect us.